Very good morning to all of you students. Welcome to the mathematics class. In this session, we will study chapter number 5 of class 12 in mathematics. And this is important chapter. The name of the chapter is continuity and differentiability. This chapter is divided into two parts. First part is continuity and second part is differentiability. And both are important. So we will discuss the whole chapter into two or more than two videos. So in the first video we will discuss some important terms. Okay, start students. First of all, I want to tell you what is the meaning of continuity. So continuity of a real function at a point is defined as a function f is said to be continuous at a point x is equal to a if limit x tends to a f of x is equal to f of a. That means if we find right hand limit, left hand limit at any point and the value of function at that point, if all the three are equal, then we can say that the function is continuous at the given point. So for the continuity of any function, three things should be equal. Okay students, now left continuous function means if limit x tends to minus a, here minus a shows left hand continuity, f of x is equal to f of a. And right continuous means a function f is said to be right continuous at point x equals to a if limit x tends to a plus f of x is equal to f of a. Clear? Now some formulas are given which is known as algebra of continuous function. So first is their sum is continuous at x equals to a. That means we can also apply the property of continuous on the two functions which are given in addition form. In the same way, we can also apply the concept of continuity on the subtraction of two functions. f minus g x is equal to f of x minus g of x. In the same way, we can apply it on the multiplication of two factors and the division of two factors. So these are known as algebra of continuous function. Now student, we will discuss here one example. Discuss the continuity of a function f of x is equal to sine square x plus x square minus 2x at the point x is equal to 0 and x is equal to pi. So here function is given fx is equal to sine square x plus x square minus 2x. And for the continuity, we have to find right hand limit at x equals to 0, left hand limit and the value of function at x equals to 0. So at x is equal to 0, the value will be, on putting the value, we get 0. And f of 0, that means the function at 0, we get also 0. So here we see that f limit x tends to 0, f of x is equal to f of 0. So we can say that function is continuous. Clear? Okay students. Now take another example. This is also an important example. In this example, discuss the continuity of a function. The function is defined fx is equal to x square minus x minus 6 upon x square minus 2x minus 3. When x is not equal to 3, that means it may be more than 3 or less than 3. So we will use this value of function for right hand and left hand limit, and when x is equal to 3, then its value is 5 upon 8. So first of all, we see here the given function on putting x equals to 0 shows indeterminate form, that means not defined form. So first of all, we have to solve it. In that case, it can be solved by the simple way. So we have to take common and factorization and putting the value x is equal to 3, then we get f x is equal to 5 upon 4, and the value of function at x equals to 3 is also 5 by 8. That means we see that f 3 is 5 by 8 and the right hand or the left hand limit is 5 by 4. So here we see that limit f x at x equals to 3 is not equal to the value of function. So we can say that the function is not continuous at x equals to 3. Clear? With the same way, we can solve more questions on the basis of concept of continuity. Okay, student, take another example. In this example, discuss the continuity of this function at a point x equals to 0 and x equals to 1. The function is defined as minus x when x is less than or equals to 0, x if x lie between 0 and 1, and 2 minus x when x is greater than 1 and less than or equals to 2. So from the given function, we can define this for x equals to 0. So for x equals to 0, the left hand limit will be limit x tends to minus 0 and minus x. So putting the value, we get 0. Now the right hand limit at x equals to 0 plus, we get also 0. So here we see that right hand limit and left hand limit at x equals to 0 will be same. Now the function, the value of function at x equals to 0 is also 0. So we can say that at x equals to 0, the given function is continuous. Okay, students. Now in the same way, we can also solve for x equals to 1. So first of all, we will find right hand limit, left hand limit at x equals to 1. So it will be 1 by putting the value in the given function, and the right hand limit at x equals to 1 will be 1 also, and the value of function at x equals to 1, it is also 1. So we can say that the function is also continuous at the same value x equals to 1. Clear? Okay, students. So you can solve such types of questions, and how can you check the continuity of function? By putting any value in the given function according to left hand and right hand limit. Okay, students. So you solve the questions of exercise 5.1, and in this exercise you can see that almost questions are just same as the examples. So you can easily solve the question of this exercise by watching the video of the example. Clear? Okay, students. Now student, we discuss the second topic is differentiability. What is the meaning of differentiability? A real valued function at x equals to a is a point in its domain, then limit h tends to 0 f a plus h minus f of a upon h is said to be derivative of fx at x equals to a, and it is generally denoted by f dash a. So it is the simple formula of derivative. Means it is the basic formula to find the derivation of any function. Clear? Now, differentiable at x equals to a, if, that is, if any function is differentiable at x equals to a, then limit x tends to a f of x minus f of a upon x minus a should be exist and finite. This is the required condition for check out any function is differentiable or not. Clear? Okay, student. Now the algebra of derivative, that means some algebraic formulas, conditions are given for the derivative functions. First, we can differentiate any two functions which are given in addition or subtraction form, and it will be differentiate individually according to sign. In the same case, we can also differentiate two functions which are given in the multiplication or product by individually using a formula, product rule. And this formula says that first function put as it is, differentiate second function, plus second function put as it is and differentiate first function. Now we can also apply the differentiation rule on the fractions function, means numerator and denominator functions. In this case, put denominator as it is, differentiate numerator now minus, and then put numerator as it is, differentiate denominator and upon square of the denominator. Clear? So this is known as quotient rule also. Now student, take some example to understand what are the properties and how can we solve the differentiation of any function. The first question, find the derivative of tan 7x plus 5 with respect to x. So here function is y is equal to tan 7x plus 5 and we have to differentiate it with respect to x. So we know that the formula of tan x, this is tan square x, and the differentiation of 7x plus 5 will be 7 into 1 plus 0, that means 7 sec square in bracket 7x plus 5. So this is the differentiation of tan 7x plus 5. In the same way, we can also differentiate another example. The next example is 5x plus 3 upon 3x plus 1 square. So here we will use two formula. First, x to the power n, and second, division rule. Clear? Okay, students. So take y is equal to 5x plus 3 upon 3x plus 1 whole of square, differentiate it according to y is equal to x to the power n. Clear? So we get 2 times of 5x plus 3 upon 3x plus 1 and differentiation of 5x plus 3 upon 3x plus 1 by the quotient rule. And we get 2 in bracket 5x plus 3 upon 3x plus 1 in bracket close 3x plus 1 left as it is, differentiate 5x minus 3, now minus 5x plus 3 left as it is, and differentiate 3x plus 1 upon 3x plus 1 whole of square. On solving, we get finally minus 8 in bracket 5x plus 3 upon 3x plus 1 square. So this is the required differentiation of given function. Clear? Okay. There are a number of examples, number of questions, and you can solve all the examples and questions according to differentiation rule and some formulas of differentiation. Clear? Okay, students. Now take another example. Differentiate sine in bracket under root sine x plus cos x with respect to x. So here function is y is equal to sine in bracket root 3 sine x plus cos x. And now differentiate it. So on differentiating, we get cos in bracket under root 3 sine x plus cos x. Now differentiation of under root 3 sine x plus cos x. So finally, on differentiating, we get under root 3 cos x minus sine x into cos x in bracket root 3 sine x plus cos x. Clear? Okay, students. So you can solve the questions of exercise 5.2 on the basis of above examples and above formulas. So you have to learn some formulas of differentiation for solving the exercise 5.2, and you can easily solve the questions of this exercise. Questions are not as tough as you can solve. You can be easily solved. Okay, students. Now students, we will discuss some other examples. Here we see some examples where x and y both are including function. That means in a polynomial form, x and y both are given. So differentiate this. If x cube plus y cube is equal to 3axy, then differentiate with respect to x. So here differentiate x cube, we get 3x square. Differentiate y cube, 3y square dy over dx, because we have to differentiate with respect to x. And 3a in bracket x dy over dx plus y d over dx plus x. Clear? Okay, students. Now differentiating and adjusting, we get finally dy over dx is equal to 3 in bracket ay minus x square upon 3 y square minus ax. This is the required solution. Clear? Okay, students. Now we take some other examples. Now differentiate tan inverse 2x upon 1 minus x square with respect to x. So here we will use substitution method. In the substitution method, we put any variable term by which we can convert the whole question into simplest form. And if we put here x is equal to tan theta, then we get y is equal to 2 tan theta upon 1 minus tan square theta. And we know that 2 tan theta upon 1 minus tan square theta is the formula of tan 2 theta. So tan theta will be cancelled out and we get 2 theta. So putting the value of theta, we get y is equal to 2 tan inverse x. And the differentiation of 2 tan inverse x is 2 into 1 upon 1 plus x square. because we know that the differentiation of 1 upon tan inverse x is 1 upon 1 plus x square. Clear? Okay, student. Now, student, on the basis of above examples, you can solve very easily the exercise 5.3. You can see here, questions are very simple. For example, if question is ax plus b y square cos x, then you have to differentiate the whole question. We are taking x as a function and y as a function of x. So if you differentiate it, then you will get a into 1, because differentiation of x is 1, and b as a constant, y square is 2y dy over dx, and cos y means sine, minus sine y into differentiation of y dy over dx. So putting the value, and finally we get minus a upon 2by plus sine y. So questions are very simple, and if you understand the topic, the formulas, learn the formulas, then you can easily solve the questions. Clear? Okay, students. Now, exponential and logarithm function. So we will discuss here some special type of function which are related to logarithm function or exponential function. So some properties of exponential function. You can see what is exponential function. See here, a function fx equals to a to the power x, where a is any positive real number, is called exponential function with base s. Now the properties are given: a to the power 0 is equal to 1, a to the power m upon a to the power n is equal to m to the power n minus 1. The same way, a to the power minus m is equal to a to the power m to the power a to the power m. If two numbers are given with same base and different power, then we can write a to the power m into a to the power n is equal to a to the power m plus n, and a to the power m whole power n will be considered as a to the power m into n. So these are the properties of exponential function, that means some powers function. Now the properties of logarithm function. So first of all, you have to learn some properties. Log x base a plus log y base a is equal to log x y base a. Next, log x to the power y base a is equal to y into log x base a. Next one is log 1 base a is equal to 0, because the value of log 1 at any base is 0. Okay, student, next property is log x base a minus log y base a is equal to log x upon y base a. Log x base a is equal to 1. So the value of log at the same base will be 1. Now, log y to the power x, we can write log x base a upon log y base a. These are the basic properties of exponential functions and logarithm function. Clear, students? Now, there are some important formulas for the differentiation. If you want to differentiate a to the power x with respect to x, then it will be a to the power x log a base e. The same way, differentiation of e to the power x will be e to the power x. Differentiation of log x will be 1 upon x. Clear, students? Okay, so now we will discuss some examples. So differentiate e to the power 2x into cos 3x with respect to x. So here there are two functions, then we can use product rule. So according to product rule, we can write here differentiation of e to the power 3x into cos 3x. So take first function as it is, differentiation of second function plus second function as it is, and the differentiation of first function. So on differentiating, we get finally e to the power 2x in bracket minus 3 into sine 3x plus 2 into cos 3x. Student, you can solve the differentiation very easily, very comfortably, but you have to learn all the formulas and you have to practice as much as possible. Otherwise, this chapter is very difficult for that person, that student which are not able to understand the formulas and practice. Clear, student? Okay. Now student, the exercise 5.4 is just depend on the above formulas, means exponential functions and logarithm functions. So you can see in this exercise only exponential functions and logarithm functions, and you can solve the questions of this exercise very easily. Okay, so see question number 3, e to the power x to the power 3.
So here, first of all, we have to take x to the power 3 as a new variable and take e to the power x formula. So we know that the differentiation of e to the power x is same. Then the differentiation of x cube will be 3x square. So its final value 3x square into e to the power x square. Clear, students? Okay. Now take another example. E to the power x plus e to the power x square plus e to the power x cube plus e to the power x4 and so on, e to the power x5. So here five functions are given and you have to differentiate by the same rule, and individually, and after that you can add all the functions and you get the required answer. Clear? Okay. Now student, in this lecture we will discuss only these topics because the video is, because the chapter is very long and there are a number of important terms, so you have to take two or more parts for this chapter. So students, you revise the exercise formula of this chapter and we will discuss the next topics and the rest topic of this chapter in the next video. Okay student, thank you very much. Do well.